I want to know whether my city is increasing the consumption of fossil fuels per capita of the city as time goes on. If it is X today, is it X plus 10% tomorrow, X plus 20% day after tomorrow, or is it plateauing, or is it going down? This watch has to be provided by the digital resource. And this is a watch that every citizen needs to become sensitive to. It modifies the behavior of the citizen. I think what we have not yet seen, but we absolutely need, is the principle of what we used to call cybernetics, which is the idea that there's information that returns to you as a feedback, and as a result of that feedback, you modify your own behavior. And that loop of informing the behavior of governments, the behavior of citizens, by aggregated information, which is real time, is what is lacking. And that's the real task of digital innovation today. The citizen wants to know how robust the basic infrastructure for water supply in his or her city is. That's what the citizen wants to know. How does he know that? He needs to know the extent to which water has to be brought from distant sources to meet his or her daily needs in the city. The external dependency on water resource has to be minimized for the city to be robust and resilient. That digital data must go back to the citizen real time. That's extremely important. My theory is, and my research finding is, that beyond certain densities, cities become inefficient. Because the infrastructure required to manage all the movement and the logistics of extremely high densities needs to be of a very high technological order and needs even more energy and input to look after it. So we want to find out where our densities are growing. When we know that the densities are now crossing what we consider to be the red line, we then decide to move to other cities, or not to move to the city where this density is approaching. At the moment, the trend in cities is driven by arithmetic solutions, numbers, and only numbers, not their environmental implications, not even their economic implications, whether they're affordable or not, not even their long-term affordability, and not even their social or cultural implications. They are not looking at those. So we just have to bring all the technicalities together, review the arithmetic solution, modify it to find the optimal result. The session that I was contributing to is a session that looked at heritage as something that can be integrated with the idea of a smart digital city. Here the learning really is that the traditional city and its patterns, whether in Asia, whether in Europe, or in South Asia, East Asia, South Asia, Middle East, and Europe, it has now been established by research that those patterns of development of dense cities, walkable, 4 or 5 stories high, are actually the lowest carbon footprint and also the most economical to build and maintain. This lesson has been learned. And this lesson has to be brought into modern planning. I think this was the big takeaway. And also the idea of not destroying the old city structures or the inherited structures of the cities, but actually looking after them and enhancing them with modern technology is something that was beneficial for the city and its citizens. That was the takeaway.